Allah Azza wa Jal described himself at the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, Anta Mawlana Fansurna Alil Qawmi Al-Kafirin, that you are our supporter. So the word Mawla comes as a supporter. It also comes as someone who is in alliance with. It comes also to describe someone who has been freed after being a slave. Like in the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to Zayd ibn Haritha, if I'm not mistaken, when he came once. We know that Zayd ibn Haritha was the adopted son of the Prophet alayhi salam before adoption was banned. So he was a slave given to Mother Khadija by her nephew Hakim ibn Hizam. And she gave this slave as a gift to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, who loved him dearly. He freed him, and then he said that this is the son of Muhammad. His name was Zayd ibn Muhammad. Until in chapter 33, Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah banned adoption. You can sponsor and support an orphan, but you cannot adopt him or her, calling him after you, giving him your name, or sharing the inheritance with your offspring. This is prohibited. So whenever the Prophet used to see Zayd ibn Haritha, he used to say that he is our Mawlana, meaning the freed slave, and he's close to me. And also the Prophet said about Ali ibn Abi Talib, Man kuntu mawlah fa aliyun mawlah. Whomever I am his mawla, his supporter, his ally, then Ali is his supporter and ally as well. And this is to show the Muslims the great place of Ali, may Allah be pleased with him. So using the word Mawlana has nothing to do with Aqeedah, in the sense that I'm using one of Allah's names with the humans. No, this is permissible because this terminology or this word or this description is shared, and there is nothing wrong with it, inshallah.